Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the civics lesson number 3, how the state government works. The last lesson we have studied about the role of government in health. What are the facilities, what are the health facilities to be provided by the government, and how many health facilities, means in India the health facilities are available in abundance, but why the government is unable to provide the proper health facilities, what are the problems while providing the health facilities to the people. Now in this lesson we will study about the role of the state government. Now children, we know that our government is divided into 3 levels: local level, state level and national level. In class 6 we have studied about the local government, that is Panchayati Raj system. In 6th standard we have studied about the Panchayati Raj system, that is the local government. In this class we are going to study about the state government. What is the role of the state government in the welfare of the people? And in the next class, that is in 8th standard, you will study about the central government. How does the central government works for the country? Now in this lesson we are going to study about the state, we are going to study about the work of the state government in democracy. How does the state government works in a democratic country like India? Then we will study about the MLA. Who is MLA? That is the member of the legislative assembly. What is the responsibility of the MLA? How does he works for the state? And all these things we are going to study. And the, that is the role of, not only about the MLA, but we are going to study about the role of MLA and the other ministers. Because in a state government also there are many people, rather we can say the ministers, who are working for the welfare of the people at the different levels. And also we will study about the debate in the legislative assembly. How does the debate takes place among the MLAs in the legislative assembly? Now we will start with the first point, that is whose responsibility. In your textbook, just open the textbook and see on the first page it is given whose responsibility, means whose responsibility is to provide the services to the people. Now we are talking about the state government, so we will keep a state in mind, and we will study in this lesson only about the state government. How does the state government works for its state? Now through the picturization they have given, the conversation between the two girls is given, that is they are reading the news which is given in the newspaper. Now how the conversation is given, just see, they are talking about the water shortage in the state and the people are falling sick. Means this is the problem given in the newspaper, and these two girls are discussing about this, that there is in our state there is so water shortage problem in so many villages, towns, cities. People are falling sick because they are not getting the proper clean drinking water and all these things. So who is responsible, who has to work on this problem? So it is the responsibility of the state government. Now we are going to study how the state government works for this, but let us first see the conversation between the two girls. Now the second point, they are talking that in many villages we found the unclean drinking water, streams have dried up, so have the tanks, the worst affected areas, villages have been carrying across the great distances. Means children, even though we say that our country is a well developed country, but still in some parts of our country, that other we can say in some of the villages, people have to struggle a lot for for the basic necessities of the life. We can say for the drinking water also, they have to walk a long distance and bring the water from the well. So this is one of the most important problem which the people are facing, that is the water shortage problem. And so it is the duty of our state government to first of all work for the water shortage problem. Then they are discussing about the another problem also, that the people are dying because of the diseases like diarrhea, cholera and so many things. Why? Because the first of all the proper facilities are not provided to the people, means the filterization of the water is not done properly. We have the people are provided the unclean drinking water, and so they are falling sick and they have to face the so many diseases like cholera, diarrhea, etc. And the people are dying because of this. So for today we have studied about the one point, that is whose responsibility. And through this conversation of these two girls, we have seen that they are discussing about the problems which the people are facing in their state, and how they have to, who has to work. And now we have come across a word MLA. So in the next lecture I will explain you about who is MLA and how he is working for the state government. So for today, as this is the introductory lecture, I have explained you about the role of the government in the health, and we will discuss more about the state government in detail in the another lectures. So children, for today only one topic I have covered, that is whose responsibility is to work for the welfare of the people. Read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you.